Hi everyone, this is Sherry from Planning Peep and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing my memory spread for the week of September 17th through September 23rd. And before we begin, I just want to apologize for my voice today. I did get sick earlier this week and I feel just fine now, but I'm just kind of recovering and my voice is still a little bit off. So hopefully that doesn't bother you too much. I'm hoping by the time I get around to recording the voiceover for this, I will be back to my normal voice. So anyways, this week was super exciting because I did go to Disneyland on Sunday, so at the end of the week, and I have a perfect kit that I've been saving for this occasion. This is from Paper Dove Shop, and it's her Disney-inspired kit, as you can tell from this girl and the balloons and these shoes. These are so, so pretty, and of course the castle. How could I forget to mention the castle? But anyways, it's so gorgeous. I love this kit so much. And I actually, when I bought this, I had no plans to go to Disneyland, but I just knew I had to have it and I held onto it until there was a week I could use it. So that week is finally here. We've got all the full boxes and then a sidebar tracker at the bottom. Here we have the bottom washi, which is this really gorgeous, like gold kind of, I don't know, dripping pattern. It's really pretty. We have the date covers and then some washi strips. And then the last sheet I purchased from this mini kit has the headers, half boxes, and quarter boxes. It has the heart check flags, icons, a big planner, bill due stickers, and then some sidebar trackers. So without further ado, I want to put down the bottom washi. And this week I want to try to pull in my Simply Gilded gold foil bow washi in this pink color, just because I think it would match really nicely. And I want to pull in some gold foil. So we'll see how I incorporate it. I'm not quite sure what I want to do yet, but stay tuned if you are interested to see how this comes together. I decided to use the thicker Simply Gilded washi as part of the bottom washi, and then it was a little tricky because I didn't want to cut off too much of the washi that came with the kit because, like I said, I really like that pattern, and so I really tried to minimize cutting where the pattern was and just take off like more of the top and the bottom of it. So hopefully that makes sense. But anyways, then I move on to my sidebar, and I chose the girl with the Mickey ears as my top corner box because I just think she's so cute, and that's kind of what I look like when I went to Disneyland, because I also have those really cute classic mini ears that I decided to wear. And then I put down all of the date covers, and I didn't have any date dots that would fit nicely into those heart shapes because the ones I have are circles and they would cover up the heart. So I decided to write in the dates myself. Then for the top corner flag, I decided to cut up one bow from the Simply Gilded washi and just cut it into a little flag shape. This actually took me a while to get down, so I had to do it several times before I liked it. And I decided to pull in the thinner Simply Gilded washi throughout the spread. I think I did it every other day just so I can pull in a little more gold foil. So I started with the sidebar, and then I put down a habit tracker for my workouts. I found this gray quarter box from my leftover stash, and I used that to mark my happy moments for the week. The heart checklist came in the kit, and then at the bottom I used a blue quarter box with the Monday through Sunday tracker from the kit to mark my dinners. Then moving to Monday, I first started by putting down a today header at the top, and then I used one of the quarter boxes from the kit layered with a gold foil heart from Clever Gal Crafts to mark that it was like a month anniversary, which is kind of dumb because we don't actually do anything to celebrate. I think I also just needed to take up some space in my planner because I didn't have that much going on Monday. I then used an IEP flag from Lily Grove Designs to mark a meeting that I had, and then I wanted to note that I got coffee actually after the meeting this day. That little quarter box is from Very Jenny Co., and the gold foil coffee sticker is from Student Planning. I then moved to the bottom because I wanted to make sure I could space everything nicely, and I put the full box at the bottom. And then for the middle space there, I pulled in a huge camera sticker from Very Jenny Co. to mark that it was picture day at one of my schools, and I made sure to do my makeup extra nicely that day. And then I used a half box to mark another meeting that I had in the afternoon, also using one of those IEP flags from Lily Grove Designs. On the full box, I first put down a shoe sticker, I think that's from Sticker Sis, to mark that I did my workout when I got home, and then at the end of the night I filmed, so I used a filming sticker from Sweet Ava's Paper with a film like script sticker, which I think is from Echo Hui Craft Co. That is pretty much it for Monday. Like I said, not super eventful and I didn't really have much going on. So moving to Tuesday, I first put down a strip of the thin Simply Gilded washi at the top. And then I found this pretty like half scallop label from Panda Bird Designs that really matched the kit with the pink color. And so I used that with a laptop icon to mark that I uploaded my plan with me that morning. And then I put down the balloons full box right underneath that. And that day we actually got some free cupcakes delivered to our school from like a local orthodontist, which I thought was really funny and ironic, but we enjoyed it nonetheless. So that cupcake sticker is from Tickled Pink Planning. I used another IEP flag from Lily Grove Designs to mark another meeting that afternoon, and then I found this little circle icon from my PG printables, and I wanted to use that to mark working out. Originally, I put this gold foil sticker from Planning World next to the heart, but I didn't really like how it looked. I felt like it just seemed really awkward, and so I ended up moving it onto the heart and just drew a little arrow to fill up that space. At the very end of the night, we watched some TV. We were watching this show called Atypical, which we really, really love. It's about this teenager who has autism and just some of the things that he encounters in his life. It's really good. And to mark that, I used a little TV icon. I think that's from Sparkly Studio. On Wednesday, I decided to hand letter or brush letter today on top of a quarter box and just create a little header. And then I used a half box from the kit to mark that it was picture day at my other school on Wednesday. So I also made sure to do my makeup extra well on that day. The camera icon is from Hazel Sticker. I then wanted to mark that I had no meetings on Wednesday, which is always exciting. So that little label is from Panda Bird Designs, and then the gold foil balloon is from Student Planning. I used a to-do header with a three-heart checklist from the kit to mark some things I had to get done at work, and then I pulled in this gold foil laptop sticker from Planning World just to add a little decoration to that and gold foil. And then I put down a quarter box from the kit with a kind of sad face emoji from the Coffee Monsters Co. to mark that I had a headache that afternoon, and I don't know why because I definitely was drinking plenty of water. I've been trying to drink more water lately. I then lifted up that quarter box and put down a full box underneath. I forgot that I wanted a full box right there. And when I got home, I did some cardio. So the cardio tech sticker is from MJ and Hope, and the workout cat sticker is from Jesse James Design Co. At the end of the night, we binged Atypical again. I think we finished the entire season, so there was like 10 episodes, which isn't that much, but I think we watched like 6 of them this night. And that TV sticker was a leftover in my collection. Then moving on to Thursday, I decided to put the full box at the top, and I chose the one with the high-heeled Mickey Mouse design. I think it's so cute. And then I pulled in a label from Very Jenny Co. to mark that I had to get gas in the morning. I couldn't find an icon that I wanted to use, and I wanted to pull in more gold foil, so I just pulled in that heart, which is also from Student Planning. Then for the half box underneath, I put down a bow paperclip sticker from Planner Frenzy to mark a meeting that I had. And then I did some editing when I got home. So I used this rose gold foiled flag, and I think that's from The Giving Girl. It was part of like a little sampler that I got when I purchased a kit, and I think it's so beautiful. I did also go and check my PO box, so I think that envelope sticker is from Dizzy Daisy Dreams. I then used another strip of the Simply Gilded washi with a three-heart checklist at the bottom, or I guess three-circle checklist. It was part of my leftovers, and then I pulled in a workout girl, and that is from Thule Plans. On Friday, I started by putting down a today header, and then I used a half box to mark that it was Friday, and I'm always super excited when it's Friday. The gold foil bow sticker is from Student Planning, and then I used a little strip of washi from the kit with a gold foil coffee sticker, also from Student Planning, to mark that I got my usual Friday coffee, which is always a treat. I put down a like busy studying girl sticker from Toffee Bananas to mark that I had a really busy day, and then that was also the day of the Planner Boss Collective sale, so I did do a little shopping. I think it had been like 2 months since I bought any stickers, so I went a little crazy during the sale. That Etsy sticker is from Hello Petite Paper. I then put down a navy blue quarter box with an icon to mark that I went to Trader Joe's after work. The white pen that I'm using is a Jelly Roll, and that was highly recommended to me for writing on darker stickers, and I actually really like how it turned out. And then that night, my friends and I did our girls' picnic night, which we try to do once a month, although sometimes it's hard to coordinate, but it's always really fun. We bring our wine and beer and a bunch of different cheeses, crackers, hummus, and charcuterie stuff, and just kind of hang out at the park park and have a good time. So I always look forward to those nights. But unfortunately, I was feeling a little sick after I got home, probably because it was kind of chilly. So I used this little sick girl sticker that I got from Jesse James Design Co. I then decided to put the double box castle on Saturday and Sunday there at the bottom, but I do end up cutting the middle part of it out. You'll see a little bit later. But anyways, moving back to the top, I put down two washi strips and layered the weekend banner right over that. And then I put down a strip of the Simply Gilded washi again. The little pink sock sticker is from Tickled Pink Planning, and I use that to mark that I did laundry that day. And then I decided to again work from the bottom because I had so many things that I did on Saturday and not enough room to mark it. But on the half box, I put down a gold foil bow from Clever Gal Crafts and noted that some of our friends stayed over for the night. They came to visit and it was super fun. We went and got dinner, played games, and had like Moscow mules all night. So it was really, really fun. Above that, I put down a gold foil bow checklist, which is from White Deer Stationery, to mark some things that I got done before our friends came over. And initially, I used that blue today or to-do header, but I do switch it out later on. The boba sticker is from Plans with Finesse. And then on top of that, I used a gold foil cleaning icon from Planning World to mark that we got some cleaning done because we knew we were going to have guests later on. Like I mentioned, I switched out the to-do header and I actually brush lettered to go on one of the washi strips that came in the kit. So here is where I decided to separate the double box into two separate single full boxes. And originally I was going to separate them just because I don't really like two full boxes next to each other in my planning. You might have noticed that I always alternate the placement of where the full boxes go, either at the top, the middle, or the bottom, but they're rarely next to each other. But after moving half of the full box to the top of Sunday, I decided I didn't really like that look. So I put them back next to each other, but just kept that middle part separate in between Saturday and Sunday. Then for Sunday, I wanted to mark Disneyland and I found this glittery half box in my collection that's from Rack Paper Stickers. And I pulled in another gold foil heart from Clever Gal Crafts. I brush lettered Disneyland on that half box. And then we actually went to California Adventures first. So I used a quarter box and put down this super adorable Minnie Mouse Maru the Marshmallow sticker from Paper and Milk. And I wasn't quite sure what to mark about Disneyland because all you do is like go on rides and then have food and walk around and look at stuff. So I didn't really know like how to mark that in my planner, I guess, which is really weird. But I ended up putting down a half box and just marking the things that we ate throughout the parks because I feel like that for me was like part of the excitement and part of the fun. So I used churro stickers and a Dole Whip from the same Paper and Milk Disney sheet to mark that we got both of those things, which is awesome. And then we also had lunch at the spot called Bingle Barbecue, which is one of my favorites. I used a kebab sticker from Plans with Finesse to mark that. And at this point, I realized that I honestly ran out of space on Sunday. I had like one last thing I wanted to mark. So I cut off just a sliver from the double box to make a little room to mark that we actually did groceries before we went home. So originally my plan was to be at Disneyland for like 14 hours from 8 a.m. to 10 p.m. But I ended up being so, so tired by the end of the night. I honestly couldn't even stay late enough to watch the fireworks, which was a really huge bummer. But I was honestly so tired, like my legs hurt and I was just ready to go home. So we didn't get to see the fireworks, but I still had a really, really fun day. And it was everything that I dreamed of and wanted it to be. So I'm just happy that we had a good time. So anyways, now I'm just filling in my sidebar, as you can see. And then once I'm done with that, I just go ahead and zoom out to show you the full spread and also the stickers that I have left over in the kit. And that is it for my Disney spread this week. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I think it turned out so beautiful. And also with all the gold foiling and everything, I just feel like that completed the entire spread. And this makes me so happy. It reminds me of Disneyland, which I don't get to go to very often. So this will hold a very special place in my heart. Again, I hope you guys enjoyed this as well. And thank you so, so much for watching as usual. Leave me a comment if you have any questions and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Bye.